guess we'll do another.
Alright.
Alright, here we go.
Hi, I'm Cookie, and if one more person adjusts the thermostat in here without my permission, I will destroy everything they have ever loved. Got that?
Alright. Yeah, but so after I get done with this project, I'll probably backtrack and find another wrong answer to the game prices I missed. So,
by the way, oh yeah, that reminds me, the one with the Sasquatch thing, you really missed it. I didn't even know
that was that obvious.
Yeah, Bigfoot is another term for Sasquatch. Yeah.
Just answer yes or no.
Is it a dog? The game?
Wow.
Then you'll win the game. How fun is that?
Here's a picture of a Siamese cat. Is this a dog?
Wow. Was that a reference from somewhere? I don't remember.
Alright, let's do this thing.
I don't know. I was just making a joke here.
Alright.
Kicking things off. High fructose fun syrup.
Oh boy.
Which of these food products does not contain corn syrup? Kellogg's Corn Pop Cereal, Brock's Candy Corn, State Fair Classic Corn Dogs, or Cracker Jack Caramel Coated Popcorn and Peanuts? Layers 1 and 2? Sorry, but most frozen corn dogs have corn syrup in them too.
Damn it!
Some more fattening, which is a huge selling point amongst frozen corn dog eaters.
Damn it!
It's corn pops, isn't it? Choose this.
It's corn pops.
Kellogg's corn pops comes merely
of course.
From sugar and the love they
it's
put
a
in.
Cereal for Pete's sake.
I like foods with as much corn as possible. That's why I'm pleased to announce my very own.
I'm gonna have my pops.
Cookie Masterson's genetically modified corn-covered corn nubbins. Well. I'm eating one now. Mmm. Oh, the cream corn and corn nuts go so well together. Mmm. Get some today.
I'm gonna stuff your face, get somebody else to ask the questions.
Open wide for Fly Me to the Cloon. And this dissertat is hurtling through the cosmos.
Great.
Oh boy, another one of those. And I get it the third time in a row.
Game. Take a run at this or that. I'm going to read off 7 titles.
That's awesome.
One, you tell me if it's a scientific publication by Galileo Galilei or
Galileo.
George Clooney movie.
Oh, George Clooney. Galileo, oh, gosh.
Press the X button. If it's Clooney,
I know. I think Galileo is the astronomer, right?
Select
I think so.
For player 2, because if you get it right and player 2 gets it wrong, you get that cash. Alrighty then, here it comes. Solaris.
Oh, what?
Gravity.
Wait, what?
The Starry Messenger.
Okay.
The Assayer.
No.
From Dusk Till Dawn. Discourse on Floating Bodies. Confessions of a Dangerous Mind.
That was horrible.
Galileo, no. You know, sometimes when I look up in the night sky into the deep expanse of space, I can't help but wonder, why wasn't Monuments Men a better movie? Just one of the mysteries of the universe, I suppose.
Alright then. I don't remember having this with that bad since one of the earlier episodes.
You know what they say about the size of a man's fret?
Oh boy.
Considering the respective sizes of their instruments, which of these male musicians is the least likely to be accused of compensating for something? A clarinet player, a piccolo player, an oboe player, or a bassoon player?
Same. Oh my gosh.
I'm gonna guess here.
Player 2, watch the time. Player 2? What a pity.
Nope.
Player 1.
Nope.
It's a piccolo, isn't it?
Oh, honestly.
Yep,
the piccolo is actually a half-sized flute and the smallest of these instruments. So the piccolo player seems the least likely to be compensating for the size of their other instrument. And as long as I've already gone through the trouble of setting up this premise, I would just like Piccolo. You know, I play a kazoo.
Yeah, I find it funny there's a DBZ character named after the flute.
Yeah, I know.
How about Alt-Shift Medicine? I've been getting into Eastern medicine lately because I hate taking lots of pills, but this is kind of weird. My specialist gave me a fortune cookie.
Oh, another one of those fortune cookie things.
Oh, it's been a while since I've seen these.
Yep.
Not that I'm complaining. I love cookies. Let's see what my fortune says. Prescription. One cookie AC. Now, weird. It's a prescription. I'm not great with medical abbreviations, though. When was I supposed to eat my cookie? First thing in the morning, before a meal, after a meal, or at bedtime? Layers one and two. Wait for it. Wait for it. Here's where the money
before a meal.
AC is a common medical abbreviation used on prescriptions and means before meal.
Never even heard of this kind of prescription before.
Took this fortune
me neither.
Wrong time. I just hope there's no side effect.
I usually take mine either in the morning or after meal or something like that. Or actually, no, bedtime.
Yeah.
That was for me when I was prescribed for pills and all that. But that's another story.
And now, till the closing credits do us part. If it followed the processional order of a traditional Christian wedding, what movie would probably have come out immediately after Bridesmaids, assuming the maid of honor is a bridesmaid? A raunchy comedy called Groomsman? A gross-out comedy called Ring Bearer? A racy comedy called Father of the Bride? Or an R-rated comedy called The Bride?
I don't care.
Player 210's running out. Player 1. In a traditional Christian wedding, the bridesmaids come out, including the maid of honor, last.
Oh my.
And the ring bearer immediately follows, then the flower girl, then the bride. The best part of the ring bearer movie is when the ring bearer comes down the aisle and steps in a huge crap left by Melissa McCarthy. Player 2. Don't soil the memory of that wholesome movie by calling it racy.
I didn't think that was it either.
That's the end of a thrilling first round. Remember, in round 2, every question is worth double. And don't forget, the wrong answer of the game is still out there waiting for you. Enough small
talk. Is this a dog? Is it a dog?
Is it a dog with game?
I'm sorry, but...
Yeah.
That is so much.
Yeah, I know.
Here's one I like to call Animation Dumbination. Which member of the Griffin family from Family Guy most likely got a recent Apgar score? Stewie, Peter, Brian, or Meg?
Oh my gosh. Oh my gosh.
No, I'll get this. The Apgar scale is a
detailed... Yes, we got it!
Yeah, because it's obvious Brian's a dog.
Griffin, a baby, experienced the most recently.
That was a pretty obvious wrong answer of the game right there.
It definitely was.
Players 1 and 2? No, Apgar scores are for humans, not dogs. But you know what is for humans? Is it a dog? The game! The newest, coolest party game from the people who brought you Which One is the Spoon and How Many Fingers Am I Holding Up?
Which one is the spoon?
The wrong answer of the game gets you a handsome $8,000. Yeah, you're welcome.
Oh, wow. This is ridiculous.
This one's known as Keep Your Hellos to Yourself.
Alrighty then.
Which one of these pop stars is giving a polite Tibetan greeting? Miley Cyrus sticking out her tongue, Justin Bieber flipping the bird, Britney Spears flashing her crotch. Goodness, player one, you're screwed. You got 5 seconds to give me an answer.
I hate you. You had to do that to me.
Yeah.
Hey, way to be wrong. Player two, you handled that screw very well.
You don't tell me it's... I don't know much about Tibet.
Oh my god.
Right, smart pants.
it too? Green.
Nope, didn't think that was good either.
Were you thinking
sticking
of this
out their tongue?
In yeah.
Tibet, some people stick out their tongue as a greeting to show you they don't have a black tongue. If they did, it would mean they are the reincarnation of a cruel 9th century king. Not
what?
That anyone would ever suspect Miley Cyrus of being the reincarnation of a cruel 9th century king. Everybody knows she's the reincarnation of Hannah Montana. Duh.
Okay. The more you know.
I yeah. call this one trivia and stuff. Where might the CEO of Linens and Things go to shop for the materials needed to make all the store's linen and things? Flax plants and things? Agave seeds and...
Oh boy, here we go again.
A new player too. 5 seconds to make a choice. Can't do anything right, can
nope,
you?
Nope, didn't think it was. Damn it.
That's how you screw player one. Grab a few more bucks, why don't you? Player one. Silkworms. Hmm. Now, I think, and I would have to double check this, that they make silk. Want to see the right answer?
Is it linen? I know. That's what I thought it was. Flax pants. Flax pants.
Not too. That's the sad part.
CEO goes to shop.
I misread that as flax pants.
Shopping for him.
Yeah.
Mean, this is a guy who is too lazy to
that's funny.
The
yeah.
Okay. Occasionally, it's a shark or a four.
Spirits.
Actually, it's rare possibility it was a four in there.
As some of you
yeah, it was a four in the last one, but this one was a shark.
Was named Dennis. Well, I'm proud to announce that today I've promoted Dennis to be a writer.
Ooh, thank you, Mr. Masterson.
It's great because not only is Dennis hilarious, I found out that I'm not legally required to pay a ghost. Which reminds me, Kyle, you're fired.
Again? But you already fired and rehired me twice this week.
Yeah, you're fired again. So Dennis, let's get you a desk and figure out how to get you the credits
wow.
at the end of the game. How should the end credits read if Dennis the Ghost writes for our former writer, Kyle Mortensen? Written by Dennis the Ghost. Written by Dennis the Ghost and Kyle Mortensen. Written by Kyle Mortensen. Or written by Anonymous.
How should the end credits read if Dennis the Ghost...
Players 1 and 2?
Nope. Damn it.
Dennis the Ghost.
Kick yourself. A ghost writer is employed to write for someone
really?
But does it under their employer's name.
Okay.
So get ready for a lot more questions about rattling chains and moaning and unfinished business, trapping oneself in this mortal realm, blah blah blah.
Ooh, I also have some ideas for questions about Breaking Bad.
No good.
All right.
Fuck her up, for. Flash him if you got him.
Oh boy.
What would you expect
that
to
sounds
see in
so
a
bad.
Spring break video called "Girls Gone: Call of the Wild"? Girls exposing themselves as they harpoon a whale. Girls lifting their shirts as they fight in the Spanish Revolution. Girls flashing their breasts in Japan for Klondike gold. Or naked girls committing cannibalism in the Andes.
Oh boy.
I don't care anymore. Who cares?
Player two.
Yep.
Player one. The novel Call of the Wild follows a sled dog and his owners during the Klondike gold rush.
That makes sense.
I have never seen Call of the Wild.
Unless you count the doodles.
Neither have I, but that was just a wild guess, really.
Yeah, it was.
Welcome to the attack. Of course, who wants to hear my yapping? Oh, I'm still doing it. Sorry. Here you go. Don't forget my advice. When it comes to do's and don'ts, let's focus on the don'ts.
Don'ts.
Oh.
Nope.
I know this one. That guy. By its cover.
Oh, I thought it was Get Glad. I'm glad that I'm glad.
I was thinking that too, but then I just see get even, so that makes sense. That's the funny part. We were both thinking the same thing on that one. Taste me, bro.
Yes! That's an old fashioned phrase. Damn you. Don't cry over spilled milk.
Don't fear. Bite your face.
Damn it.
Don't fear the Reaper. That's a song by the Blue Oyster Cult.
Yeah, I was getting that.
Don't mess.
Yeah, I don't think that pet. First one was it.
Don't mess with spilled milk. Don't mess with Texas.
Yes!
Damn you!
Don't bite
the hand that feeds you. That was wrong. Oh, that was... Don't bite... Oh! That...
Yep.
Yeah, I knew that was wrong. It was don't bite the soap. Don't hate the plate. Love the... Oh. Hate the game.
Dang it.
Don't ask, don't tell.
Ah, I forgot about that. It's been so long since I've heard that one.
Oh, man. That was awesome. That was pretty good. I think I won.
Yeah, you did. Player one
takes it. Over 9,000.
Yeah. Yeah, over 9,001. Wow. Obvious dive. Have you no dignity? And another
thing. Well, that's 2-1 right there.
Yeah.
Oh, man. That was fun. That was fun.
Yeah, still no luck.
Nope. Unfortunately not. Yeah.